In terms of total number, it's a small number that we're sending out today. I think only 20 are going out today, and total batch was 32 young professionals who are headed to Germany. But it's not about the statistics, because every one of those 32 can be a change maker, can be an influencer, and is an ambassador, as Ved ji said, rightly put it, because you're going to open pathways for so many others. In a sense, this is a start, it's a small start, and it's very encouraging to expect 32 young students to pick up a language in such a short amount of time. I'm flabbergasted, I'm shocked. I'll use your example and tell my daughters that they're learning Spanish and they're struggling with it. I'm saying if these girls from Kerala, from Himachal can go to Chandigarh and knock out a language in 2 months, there's nothing you can't achieve. And like Veji was telling us what the process was, the trainers came in and from day one they started talking in German. Sounds harsh. Sounds really harsh. But clearly it works. So I'm going to go home and talk in only mathematical terms now. Maybe my children will be better at maths. Anyways, today is not to poke fun at my children. We are here to celebrate you, your achievement. And like our secretary of our ministry is here, he spoke about the various partnerships that we have in place. NSDC has very ambitious plans. And of course, there is a gap. Even in a contracting global economy, NSDC has calculated that there's a skill gap. By 2030, it's expected that 8.5 crore opportunities are going to be there in the world. How many of those roles and positions can be filled by skilled Indian aspiring students, our young people? That will decide the future path for our society and our nation. You look at Germany, leading European economy. Yes, an aging nation, perhaps compared to India, though our ambassador is very youthful, full of vigor. But the mean age there is, in Europe, is 45. Here it's 28. And it's often talked about in policy circles that India has a great demographic dividend, and that is a clear path towards transforming our country, our rural hinterland, and ensuring that we are a developed economy by 2047. Whether we're able to harness that demographic dividend efficiently, effectively, is going to decide that. Talking about Germany, we have a long tradition in terms of economic partnerships. There's a number of agreements that we have undertaken. For 2 years, His Excellency the Ambassador has been here in India, and it is perhaps part of his vision and his vigor that under his leadership here and his efforts, a lot has come about. Chancellor of Germany visited India twice in 2023. This has been an election year for us, and I think that process is going to continue at pace. We have an agreement, a mobility partnership in place. We're targeting a lot of cooperation in the space of green energy and new technology. And I think German technology and German achievements in that space are well respected world over. And at the same time, when you talk about mobility, when you talk about 8.5 crore jobs by 2030, positions that are open there in the world, if you look at Germany, I was reading a Reuters report in 2023, they said that half of the German companies are struggling to fulfill their jobs. They don't have labor. And 1.8 million jobs are available right now for the right skilled person, for the right skill. So it's of tremendous importance that, and it's the right approach, as the ambassador pointed out, that they're doing it in a targeted manner, in a focused manner. And that is only possible when you partner with strong partners who have on-ground presence at the grassroots. And I think NSDC has great potential. NSDC also wants to increase the numbers that we're reaching out to right now. And it was there in the presentation, 58,000 people have been placed outside India. that number can grow tenfold, 100-fold. So the world is our oyster. This is just the beginning. And then again, thank all the partners, all our officials. And like I said, mostly for bureaucrats, in politics I still get to travel, meet people of all different hues of walks of life. But you are stuck in offices all day long. One meeting after another meeting after another meeting. So great that we got an opportunity to meet students. It was a really well-organized function today. I commend the whole team, and I reiterate how proud we are of the achievements of the young people here.
If you like the video, do like, comment, share, and subscribe.